top 8 data center electrical design resources, courtesy of SP Home Run's Guide to Lead Generation Best Practices for Colocation Data Centers. Electrical power is often by far the biggest ongoing expense in a data center. As an indication, compared with the power consumption of an equivalent size office block, a data center uses about 40% more and places conditions that are significantly more stringent on the availability of power too. From HVAC, computing equipment and lighting, to perimeter alarms, badge readers, and coffee machines, nothing works if the power is out. Data center electrical design, therefore, benefits from careful consideration and good resource. How much power do you need? So that you can start with the end in mind, these resources to help calculate the power a data center needs. Data center power requirements is an easy-to-read introduction that continues to be relevant even if it dates from 2001. Among other things, it explains why many data centers waste money because of over-dimensioning for power. Calculating total power requirements for data centers gives sample calculations and a worksheet to help you put together a first cut of power requirements. For IT equipment power needs in particular, you can make estimates by using this online data center power calculator. Electrical safety and data centers. Remember, safety first. To design safety in your data center electricals from the start, check out the following resource. Electrical safety describes the need for safety, the roles of different actors in the design and implementation of electrical systems in building, and relevant building codes to observe. A further link is given for safety or regulatory organizations listed. Training on electrical architectures and equipment. After figuring out your power needs and understanding safety rules and regulations, it's time to find out about possible installations and equipment. The Data Center Energy University offers a wide range of online training courses covering subjects like rack and row cooled architectures, battery technology, comparisons of AC and DC power distribution choices, and scalability, reconfigurability, and efficiency in data center power distribution configurations. Additional best practices information. All the above can already give you a solid grounding in data center electrical design basics. The following practical information can then help you consolidate what you know. Dollar figures on costs for Tier 2 and Tier 3 data centers are part of these best practices to design data center facilities. The data are from 2005, so work in a suitable factor for inflation. The guide also includes additional content about optimizing your approach to a data center, allowing you to put the information on the electrics into the broader perspective of the data center operations as a whole. Alternatively, 7 best practices discuss cooling, power, and power backup aspects with a handy checklist at the end to make sure you're covering the bases. Making the data center electrical design. The final step is to draw up the design. Forget those rolls of papers and blueprints. With the right electrical design software, you can do it all digitally. Download. Potential advantages include automatic estimating, rapid updating and ease of sharing, and collaboration between designers, contractors, and owners. Which data center electrical design resource have you found to be most useful? Share your opinion with other readers in the comment section below. You can also download a copy of this guide while it's still available at www.datacenterleadgen.com. Thanks so much for stopping by and tuning in today to learn all about top 8 data center electrical design resources.